All right, welcome back. In the previous module, we have seen how we have integrated our launching browser model with the Ori framework. So we have integrated launching browser workflow after the init all application workflow, because we have the init all application workflow will read all the config data and put it in one of the argument that is called inconfig, and we have to use the same arguments into this another workflow, our launching browser workflow. Here also we have used the same variable inconfig so that it is passing data onto this another workflow as well. So whenever we access inconfig of some key, then we will get the value of that. Okay, so in this video we will see how we can make better, in the sense like instead of hard coding values, how can we get it from the config file. Let me get into this workflow. If you see over here, I have made some changes over here. Let me get into first the changes why I did it for. Yeah, the first thing is like here, open browser, we have specified the URL of the application. This we can place it in our config file and we can read it for the, I mean, read it dynamically. This is the one thing we can change. Another thing is, in the where we download the application, while downloading the input data, so we have hard coded the location for it. That also we can place it in our config file. So how we can place it? Let me check. Yeah, so I have replaced with dynamic values. What I did is, so we are saving our input data. Let me get into the folder where we are saving our file. So I'll just go to my project, whatever Ori framework created. So data, inside data we have a folder called input, and input here we need to save our input data.slsx. For that, what I did, I used the .NET function path.compile. Environment.current directory means it provides the current directory path. And from the config value, I am getting the download path and the file name. If you go to our config file, let me go to config file, config.slx. Here, I have included three key value pairs. The first is for site URL. Okay, site URL I have given here, and download path and file name. To simplify, I have separated it out. Otherwise, I can give it everything in one combination. Okay, so these three key value pairs we have to read. For the downloading file location, I have combined path.combine, environment current directory, inconfig download path and file name. And for the site URL, just I use the site URL.toString. Let me test how it works. So testing these values, I have placed two message box and I kept the same code to check the values. Let me run this application. I'm running the whole process now. Let me close Excel sheet as well. Okay, so what happens once the robot start executing the process, then it will launch the website and show the message box. So first we are getting the RPA channel website URL. That's fine. It's reading data from the config. Yeah, and also we have got the location where we need to save the file, input data file. Thank you for watching this video.